Hello friend, good morning. Welcome back to our channel. Here we talk general and electrical aspect.
In today's web interview, we have Ms. Namrata Vitas. She is an electrical graduate. She completed her electrical engineering BTEC in 2013, and then she worked for institutes, IITs, so JEE coaching institutes like the JEE, NEET, and others as a physics lecturer. And then she pursued her M.Tech. All topics are very much interesting. For example, she did her M.Tech in power system and power electronics background. So, at the same time, she did her as an intern at IIT Bombay. So that course also is very nice. So, see, in this video, she clearly explained everything in detailed manner. I can say her profile is a perfect fit. I mean, everything is properly aligned. So generally, if you are doing any one action, that should take hours to the next level. I observe that things in his profile. So whatever she did, like it may be physics lecturer for it may be internship at the selection of the M.Tech branch, everything, and the courses she did simultaneously, like AutoCAD, Dialux, or ETAP, so Udemy courses, NPTEL courses. So whatever courses she did, everything is bringing her to the next level of maturity with respect to the knowledge and proficiency and everything. So this is a perfect profile. You can completely go through the discussion. So it may benefit many. So she is also university topper. So she explained her view very clearly. So, and one more thing, apart from this, the women in electrical industry. So whether women is suitable for electrical industry or not, what things they have to take care, how they can be very much benefit better with respect to knowledge, technology and all. Everything she clearly explained. So I can say any fresh graduates, the people who are in electrical engineering in their second, third or fourth year of their education, are the people who are pursuing M.Tech, are the people who wants to do any certification courses so that they can get better opportunities in their career, they all can watch this video. I divided this video into the two parts, so it may benefit many professionals. I think we can watch this video. If we have very less time, we can click on timestamps also. I given timestamps also about each topic, the relevant topic you can view. But I can say any electrical graduate, they can watch this video at least once in their life so that they also can get proper understanding everything in a proper manner. So keep watching, guys. If you also want to be a part of these interviews or some way, if you want to contribute your knowledge, if you want to share your knowledge, then please comment me, please approach me so that I will make a plan to that. Keep watching.
Okay.
Yeah. Nice to meet you.
Okay, fine. Yeah, same here. I'd also like to thank you for giving me this opportunity, for sharing my experience and, you know, giving helping hand to someone who really needs it.
Yes. I am happy. I'm happy to meet you. Welcome to our channel, ALP Talks.
Okay, sure. Thank you so much.
Yeah, nice. So, how are you? How are things going on there?
Things are going good, except things are like everything is good in Mumbai except the transportation thing, because the local trains are the main transportation and they are not started, so things are not that good.
Metro's not started, right?
Metro has started, but the local trains that run, so that is main connecting thing between like different cities, small cities of Mumbai. So because of that, many people are facing problems, and even many people are losing their jobs, and many things like people are facing out there because of that.
So
that is one criteria. Except that everything is much under control.
Yes. I think many of you people may be habituated for public transport, maybe buses, trains and all. Now,
because it is very difficult in Mumbai to travel without a train. So that is one of the aspects because of which they are suffering. And from safety point of view, the measures taken by government are good. But when it comes to like local people like us, then it is very difficult. And that is the reason recruitment and everything is not going that good in Mumbai as compared to other cities of India.
Yeah, actually, Mumbai is a very hot spot in the country from starting days of COVID. Yeah, I also heard that news every day, a little bit stress. I mean, it's a very stressful also at the initial days. Continuously, 20 days, I followed the news. After that, I stopped following.
True. It was like listening to news was also very stressful. It was like that.
Regularly, I'm just initially, what is the count there? What is the count here? Everything I am following. I stopped it up. Now I don't know what is the count nowadays.
Yeah, actually, when it was starting, what we used to do was that there was a website, right? They used to continuously monitor number of cases all around the world. So we used to keep track, and then it was like nothing is under control. The numbers are going up, and now that was becoming very stressful to, you know, even open that site and see that we stopped everything.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, for example, that Aarogya Setu, whatever app is there, if I'm moving to Bangalore for airport, I'm seeing so many people around me positive also. I mean, in that app, COVID.
true.
Yeah, it gives a little bit of stress. Oh, who is affected? So many people. Yeah, till reaching Bangalore, it's fine. Very rare, maybe 20-30 kilometer range it's showing. Once approaching Bangalore, it's showing so many positives. So I stopped seeing that notification also.
Even I did the same thing.
Only thing, we should be careful. That's it. Nothing else.
And now it is like everyone should take self-care. It is only like that. We can't do anything else.
It's like mask and all, everything. That's like common thing.
Now, it's like in Mumbai, if I can describe, it is like people have given up. Many people have given up. Like, it is almost like wherever we go, it is very crowded in Mumbai. So, many people are like, now everything has become normal, so they have started giving up on things from safety point of view.
Most places started busy.
Anywhere you go to malls, you go to like normal kirana stores, or you go to any beach or anything, it is like so crowded. Like, people are not concerned now. It is almost like that here.
Yes, nice.
It's good. Like, it is coming back to normal. That is very good. Like, we have never seen Mumbai coming to halt. So, like, now we are feeling good. Like, Mumbai is back on track.
Yeah. I think pollution and all, everything is now very less under control, we can say, nowadays in all the major cities.
Things are better now. Hopefully, it gets better by June, and like, even we get good opportunities. That's prime importance. Like I have came across many people, even who are experienced, like they are facing too much problems from their career point of view. Now it's like we are just hopeful that everyone is safe and everyone is at least, you know, they have something to work on. They are earning enough to look after their families and everything.
Yeah.
Like, we heard lots of stories, and it is like not good.
Okay. Yes, that's true. Yeah, many people staying at home, they can utilize this time for many knowledge things also. Well, like any doing.
Sure.
I can say that for students who are preparing for GATE or any exams or any jobs who are serious, they can best utilize this time. Yeah. Very nice.
Yeah, I can say I have utilized so much. Like, I completed, like, almost in August, we were done with all our submissions. Like, everything was online. Like, in post-graduation, your project part is taken very seriously, right?
Yes.
After that, I was like, what should I do, like, best utilize? Like, you know, 1 year down the line, even if I'm going and approaching some company, they should at least appreciate, like, you made some effort to, you know, learn things. So I was like, I should at least learn some or the other thing to keep myself busy. And also, you know, you get much knowledge about what actually is going on in the companies and how you can prepare yourself so that when you go for interview, like they should at least feel that you have a capability or you can work hard in achieving something. So I can tell from my experience, like I utilize this time in a very good way.
Yeah,
like I did many of the courses like on now nowadays many good online platforms are there, like Udemy is there, Coursera is there, then even on YouTube you have many people like you making videos and educating people. No, it is really appreciable, you know, like when people make such kind of videos, like there are many students out, you know, they need some guidance, but there are not many people out there who can help them out. So now nowadays this online platform has become such a good platform where everyone can contribute towards helping each other. So there are many good things. So only thing is you should be dedicated towards utilizing all this. I can say it has brought a luxury of sitting at home and doing things, but you should be hardworking and, you know, grabbing those opportunities So I can say that.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. We should utilize these times, because these times may not come again. We can't say like that, but that much time we can't see many people who are very, very big CEOs as they are sitting at home. They are spending some time with their family simultaneously. Yeah, myself also get some good exposure. I mean, I didn't imagine that I could work at my hometown for 6 months. I didn't expect it.
Okay.
Because
daily. But many of my friends who also went hometown and they were doing like work from home and they were also enjoying that. We don't get so much time to stay at our hometown and at the same time work also. So it was advantages also, but it was disadvantage for many people as well. Mm-hmm. We can't say like that.
Yeah. Well, I am recollecting one word. My earlier manager used to say, BTech means bahar. You have to stay bahar outside of your house. That's it. I mean, you are out of city. Like that, you should feel something like that. Right. Easier to say. Whenever I'm asking for any leave, no, you should not feel homesick. You have to stay outside. BTech means bahar. That's it. Good thought.
Everything
somehow this situation helped many people apart from who lost their lives. That tragedy is still there, but still I think this given some good change to the society and people.
True.
Yeah, thanks for sharing your experiences about your you faced in so let's move into our topic. So we want to know a few things about your education and professional background, because we are going to spend some time, so it's better. So it's your turn, dear. Welcome again to our channel. Let's start.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah,
you can ask like some questions, right?
Accordingly, we can
get into the conversation.
I will surely ask questions. I mean, you are an electrical graduate, right?
Yeah. Electrical. I completed my post graduation in electrical engineering with specialization in power electronics and power system in August 2020, and my overall CPI is 9.54.
Very nice. Yeah. So here I am getting one doubt about this your M.Tech graduation. I mean, power system and power electronics, those two generally don't go hand in hand in many colleges, many universities. Those are generally two different subjects, two different applications, two different job fields. Everything is different. Mm-hmm. How you got this branch in a thing for you, for example? Anybody will treat like power system graduation is completely different, power electronics is completely different. So I'm thinking where you will get job. I mean, mixing up both, it is something very strange, but yes, you can go anywhere. That's true. But
both the fields open. I would definitely, this is a very good question. Many of the students, you know, who are willing to take up this course, they even ask me on the LinkedIn the same question, like what actually this branch is and what actually it has in store, but to be very specific, I'd like to say first thing this is not a new branch. Like this combination is not a new branch. It is new for people who have, you have done your BTech or specialization either in power system or power electronics. But basically, if I see renewable technologies, like, right, PV technology is coming and many renewable technologies like wind is there, e-vehicles is there. This is all basically application based. Like it is an application of power electronics and power system. Like without power electronics, all these technologies cannot work. So it is basically what happens is now, for example, in a normal electrical language, if I say whatever the supply that we get from renewable sources, for example, let us say PV sources, if I say it is in the form of DC, right?
Yes.
So you have to regulate that DC. You can't directly feed, because feeding into grid, you will need it in an AC form. So you need some converters, right? So those converters are basically what your power electronics device. And this generating and feeding into grid is basically your power system. So the combination of these two is completely this branch, power system and power electronics. You can say it is an application-based thing. There is many things into this. This was just an example to explain like what actually this branch has. Like without this power electronics, many of this new upcoming technologies won't work. You need converters, you need battery storage system, you need battery management system and many more things. So
yeah,
this is what actually this branch has in store.
Okay. Yeah, is there any, I mean, how many colleges are offering this? Only EOs?
Even IIT, like I used to do my, I had my internship at IIT Bombay. Even they have this branch for their M.Tech as well as for the PhD. They have many projects based on this branch. Like it is power electronics and power system. I am not sure about other IITs, but yeah, there are many colleges and many IITs who are providing this kind of course. And this is not the only new course like what our college is providing. So this is very much not new. But it is like not many people might be aware of, because either they are specialized in power system or power electronics like that.
Yes. That's true. Mm-hmm. Because I didn't observe in my AP Andhra Pradesh, because I too had a thought of, I am only a graduate only, BTech graduate. I had a thought of pursuing M.Tech at that time. So I didn't find such courses. That's why I got a little bit curious.
Even like when I was going to select my branch, I was not sure about it. Like then I did a lot of research and lot of activity. Like I also interacted with lot of people, and from that I came to know like what exactly this branch is, and more of it I got after entering into this branch exactly.
Okay. So have you got, I mean, is this any entrance exam is there in your state, or have you got for the
have to appear for GATE, and based on the GATE score we get admission into this course.
I think you might enjoy it a lot, this course, because it's not like only particular mixed new thing, new domain. I think there is not much material available outside also. But still, it is an enjoyable course, I can say myself.
Yeah, it was good. And lot of research is going on into this field. So it is not like that contents are not available. Lots of books are there. Lots of people are working. And
You are muted. Please unmute yourself. Yeah, proceed. I am not able to hear you, Namrata, still. Think. Please unmute. Yeah, now okay.
Am I audible now?
Yes. Please proceed.
So it is like lot of things are available, because this is very new and upcoming things. People are working, and many of the PhD people especially are going into this research thing. And maybe these researchers are new in our country, but in the outside of India, a lot of work have been done on this particular branch. So it is not very, we can't say it is new, but it's only like awareness might not be there among the people about what exactly this is.
It's almost mature technology then. I mean,
yeah, it is, and many things are still upcoming. So, like, there is a lot of things to work on.
One more thing about this MTech only. Generally, people will think only BTech is sufficient, generally in core fields, because most of the jobs are with BTech only. Very few jobs need MTech, except research fields, some DRDO, some very, except few companies remain, most of the things you can refer, government jobs, everything need BTech only. So what you made to pursue MTech? Why you thought it's good, or any personal interest towards, love towards electrical, or what?
first my motive was, like, after doing my BTech, first thing was always doing post graduation was on my mind. But, you know, many of my friends went for MBA, many people went for different kind of post graduations, I don't know. But like, I was interested into staying in the core, you know, electrical background itself. And like, after BTech, I was like, yeah, there is more to learn about this subject, you know. You know, electrical is not that easy branch. Like, when we are into BTech, and we study and we give exam, that time we don't actually realize, you know. We like, many people say, "Arey, electrical is very, you know, tough." At that time, I don't know, like, you might have also felt, "Arey, why the people are saying, like, it is very tough?" But when we actually get into practical field or job field, we do realize that it's so complicated. It's so, like, you know, you should know how exactly application is. Like, you know, when you go for interview, someone might ask you question, like, for example, anything, like, you know, how to design, design a transformer, how do you decide a KVA rating of transformer? It is not like we have not studied in our BTech, but when it comes to interview, we start thinking, you know, I have studied, I don't know how to calculate. And when we go back and read the book, we are like, arey, this is so normal formula, we already know it. So, you know, when I did my BTech, after that, I was feeling something is lacking, you know, you should know more about the subject. And especially if it comes to IITs, na, I say IITs or NITs, this college courses are designed application based. But when it comes to normal colleges where you pursue engineering, it is not, application based. It is just a general, you get idea about what exactly is the engineering. So when you go for interview, it's very difficult to, you know, answer those application based questions. So I was like, no, there is more to learn to this subject. And, you know, when I did MTech, I did realize that when you do MTech, you actually understand many of the, you know, because in MTech, you have some advanced courses. And when you study those advanced courses, you understand the basic level in much better way. So I feel if you want to have, and if you can do it, like, many people are like, BTech, after BTech, I want to join a company, I want to start earning. But if you really want to learn more about the subject and you're interested in core, I do suggest that, MTech is a good platform where you can get to learn more about the subject and understand electrical engineering in much better way. I hope, like, you know, agree with this. But this was my personal experience. I did always felt that there is more to learn about the subject before, you know, starting a job or doing something.
That's good. That's true, actually. Because once you come out of the BTech, if you join some companies, we don't get chance to learn all the things again. I also feel that if anyone has a no burden of financial things from the family, have any little bit commitments, means it's better they can pursue some higher courses.
Yeah,
in life only one time we will get chance to do any MP.
Yeah, even for me it was very difficult. I would like to share experience, like, after BTech, like, I was not able to start my MTech immediately. I had to, you know, I had some responsibilities. At the same time, I was like, if I get into corporate, I won't be able to concentrate in my, engineering, like, for entrance preparation or something. And at the same time, I was like, I have to keep touching this with the subject so that, you know, I can, whenever time comes when I can start my MTech, it is not like everything is gone away. Because even if you must be agreeing on this, if you don't study anything for like say 1 year also, no, you tend to forget. Like if you, for example, if you are into transformer designing, and if I ask you something related to motor designing, you won't be able to recollect, right? Yeah. So this is the problem. So I was like, I have to keep the track of the subjects the entrance. At the same time, I had some, you know, responsibilities. So I was like, you know, first get into teaching. Teaching is a field, you know, where you can teach many subjects, stay in touch with it. At the same time, you can earn also and, you know, prepare also for whatever you're planning for your higher studies.
Yes,
so that was one way I found out like how I can manage the things also, stay in touch with the subject. And I would like to share that when I got into like M.Tech, let's say from after 4 years of, you know, into teaching, when I started, I was like first day, I was like, yeah, I was into teaching and now again becoming student, it was so difficult for me to digest, you know, that thing. So I was like, but no, with time you can accept that thing. But I would suggest that it's always better if you can start immediately rather than taking a break, because you know, with a flow you can do things. After break it does become difficult.
Yeah.
And it is not that easy, you know, going into professional life and coming back into a student life.
Yeah.
So I would suggest always better to, you know, start as early as you can.
That's true. But the understanding levels you got after some professional things, it's very high, I can say. I mean, if you come directly after BTech, the understanding levels are a little bit different. You worked in some professional field for some time. The mind is so matured with respect to the technology, knowledge, whatever you study, it's not like for the sake of exam, I can say. It has a purpose for you. Whatever you studied, some purpose is there to serve at the end. So your skills and everything will change. Yeah, one thing I want to mention here, you told about application-based engineering things in IITs and NITs. Yeah, that's true. That's what I need in our regular colleges and universities also, state
universities,
state colleges. Yeah, there we are studying like in schools we may study tables, one into two, something like that. So it's almost, I can say, similar to that, nothing else. That's what most of the colleges, they are, because they should create some application based things somehow to the curriculum, somehow to these students, so that their thinking will change a lot, drastically changes. If at least in every semester one or two such things are getting involved. That aspect is required in colleges also, but I am not sure when those things will come into effect. So that
actually,
they proceed.
Actually, what I feel is, you know, this point should be brought somewhere at the, you know, highest point, that India really needs to progress somewhere. They need to, you know, like IITians are there, but most of the IITians are hired by multinational companies and, you know, many good companies like, say, Siemens, and all hire like IITians only.
That's true.
So if we want that, like, you know, India can make out best from their engineers or India, so they should invest in good colleges in addition to IITs and NITs also. They should do something for the, you know, state colleges and other colleges also, so that, you know, everyone gets that opportunity who is actually interested into much of the, you know, if they can't do much of the things, but then they should make available like, you know, small internships, or they can even create some, you know, seminars or something from the industrial experts or something. So many such measures, if small measures also they take, it will be very helpful in bringing out good engineers out of, you know, India. Well, it is not like we are not capable, but can you hear me?
Yes.
It is not like that many people are not capable, but there is capability in many engineers, even from the state colleges and different government colleges. Only thing is, if India, our government takes some initiative even to do bit about the colleges, state colleges, we would be having better engineers and better opportunities out there.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. There are so many things the government has to take care, at least as a starting push up. Yeah, I love that NPTEL concept. NPTEL concept, it's very nice. What government...
I just see it.
Yeah, because it's from that is only thing I can say is helping other than IIT and IIT people, because everybody is using those materials somehow, because everyone may not find that much resources in their colleges or personally they can't afford those things, but NPTEL things made everyone's life, students' life particularly, is very easy. We need many initiatives, what you told, the seminars or something, some they can come. Yeah.
True. NPTEL is really a good platform. I can share one experience of mine. I did recently two courses. One was Power System Protection and Switchgear. This is very basic actually subject that is taught even in BTech colleges also. But just to brush up my knowledge, because in this pandemic time, I wanted to spend much of the time, you know, even revising things, because when we go for interview, many things from different subjects are asked, right?
That's true.
So I just pursued that course, Power System Protection and Switchgear. And when I learned that course from one of the IIT professor, I understood it in such a better way, like the way they teach and the, you know, they always teach from application point of view, and even small things are, you know, considered while teaching. It is not just ki, yeah, this is MCB and bus, this is the definition. Like many small things are considered in teaching. And, you know, if the same kind of teaching, if it is there in many good state colleges, then I can definitely say we will have a very good engineers out there. So NPTEL is like, this is a very good initiative. Like we have access to many of the good courses taught by IIT professors, and that will be really helpful for students who come from state colleges and everything. So this is really very helpful. People should do it whenever they get the opportunity and time to do such courses.
That's true. That's true. Yeah. Is anything we have to pay money for NPTEL, or how can you explain a bit?
Yeah. NPTEL is like, if you just want to access the lectures, you don't have to pay anything. Mm-hmm. But if you are interested in giving their examination, you have to pay a fee. There is some payment or registration fee of 1,000 rupees. You have to pay that fee if you want to appear for exam and get the certificate. If you just want to access the lectures, you don't have to pay anything.
Okay. Either certificate hard copy or just the soft copy they are sending to mail, how it is?
Yeah, initially they were sending hard copy as well, but now they have stopped. Like they are just sending the soft copy. There is no hard copy they are sending.
Okay. I mean, how the examination, level and all, it's like IIT or but, it's like normal, or can you talk about it a little bit?
Yeah, the examination is basically like when you are pursuing some course, there are different courses. Like there are 4 week course, there are 8 weeks, there are 16 week course. So whatever course, like let us say if I'm going for an 8 week course, then every week I will be given one assignment. It will have somewhere around 8 to 10 questions. And, you know, there is one criteria that some marks that I don't remember exactly, but some minimum marks, average marks should be some 25 out of 100 or something. It is like that. So of all the assignments that you submit, your average should be that much to get the certificate. And for the examination also, they have some criteria, like there is 75 marks or something. I exactly don't remember. So if you meet both the criteria, then only you'll get the certificate.
Okay.
Like that. Uh-huh. And second thing is, after giving assignments every week, submitting every week, based on those lectures and assignment, whatever questions, what kind of questions they asked in assignment, based on that only examinations are also there. Like it is nothing like GATE or something. It is just about learning the subject and just to see whether how much you have studied and understood the subject. Based on assignment and lectures only, you have the examination questions. It is MCQ kind of questions only.
Okay.
2 marks. 1 mark questions will be there, and you have to solve and submit it. It is same like GATE only, but the level is not that high like GATE. You cannot use your calculator. There is a gate calculator that we use now. The same calculator we have to use.
Okay. Almost similar.
It was a good
yes.
Yeah, concept is similar, but the examination is based on the course and assignment that they give.
Yeah.
Nothing extra from outside is asked like that.
Okay.
But it is good for the understanding of the subject. You know, you really get to learn it in a different way.
Okay. Are you interacting with any professors, sir? It's only recorded classes. What you say about that?
It is recorded classes, and there is one forum where you can, you know, post your doubts and some everything, and they revert back with whatever your doubts is. They'll clear on the same forum. They'll reply you or whatever the solution is there. Even a solution of each of the assignments are also given after submission.
Okay.
So everything is provided by them. Only thing is, if you can give some time, so you will be able to learn the subject in a good way.
Okay. Generally, how much time you will take? You will do daily for that course. How much duration you will spend?
Okay. I took two courses, right? So every like 5 lectures a week was there for both the subjects. So in 1 week, I have to complete my 10 lectures and at the same time submit both the assignments. So every day, like I used to see two lectures, like, and then like in 5 days I used to complete, and mostly on Saturdays I used to submit my assignment.
Okay.
So like it is also not like it is time consuming. Every lecture is depending upon like professor to professor, it varies. But average, if I say the length of the lecture goes from 35 to 40 minutes. So you can easily see 2 or 3 lectures, like you can make out. Like if you are at home, like in the times of pandemic, you can make out 3 to 4 hours for yourself if you are working like
yes,
that.
Yes. That's true. Nice. You explained everything clearly what you did. Yeah, why I am going to details is our discussion may benefit many professionals. They can also feel the things. Okay, they also get, oh, this many things are there. We also can do like that. They can feel some.
It can be helpful to many people in many ways.
Yeah, it may motivate them. That's why I'm asking so many questions also. It may be my personal question also.
No, it is like, you know, to help someone is really good, because when I completed my BTech, after that, I was also feeling, you know, at that time, no one was utilizing this platform in a way we are utilizing it right now.
That's
so, you know,
true.
At that time, many times, like between selecting my M.Tech and like, you know, what I should exactly do, where I can balance everything, I always needed that. If there would have been some experienced person from this background who would have guided me, I would, you know, I would have done things in a better way, and I would have done things in a, you know, quicker way, you know.
Yeah.
But it, for me, the journey was like I learned it in my way and did it. So it was time consuming, but you know, I would like to share my this experience with many people out there so that they cannot face the same problem.
Yeah, I always feel same thing, like what you're feeling. Mm-hmm. If anybody guided me in my schooling or inter or BTech, I done 10 times better. I always feel that nobody, I mean, it's not like nobody guided me. My personal background is like that. My village background, educational, because many people are like that. So they may not have access to many things. Are those things, for example, I am the first person to come out educated in my house, my family, I can say entire family. So like that, there are so many people who don't know anything. Somehow they struggle, they come out. Yeah, but still, I'm feeling that.
It is very relatable. I can say even I do come from the same background. I'm the first person to, you know, who has done engineering from my family background. So for me, it was very difficult. You know, I always felt I needed someone always, you know, somewhere. It was not like they were not helpful, but you know, when we are into engineering, if someone is from the same background, they can guide us in a better way. It is not
That's true.
Our family couldn't support us. Yeah, they didn't give that support. But it is more of like if someone is from same background.
Yeah, that's, you are muted. Please unmute.
So it will be, it would have been in a other way.
That's true. Yeah, family help is limited to some extent. They may provide some facilities.
True.
if you are fully sick, they may help you up to that extent they can do. They may not teach more things, so it's better. Yeah, I also feel that we should have anyone mentor throughout our life. It's for general discussion, general talking. Yeah, it may be anyone. You can feel it may be your lecturer, your teacher, or whatever they may be. Yeah, we should have one in our life so that we can get we can feel better. Yeah, that's true. Okay.
Yeah, definitely.
nice. So, other course what you done apart from power system for switchgear protection? Other is what from NPTEL?
That is distribution system analysis. That was one course we didn't had, like I didn't had that course either in my BTech or MTech. So I wanted to do that course. Like I went through, like there is a course outline given, right? So I went through it. So what I found out, whatever we study, like in our BTech or we did it in our MTech, it was you must also be aware of this load flow analysis we do, short circuit analysis and everything. But what we have studied, that was for transmission system. But when it comes to distribution system, all this analysis changes because there are many differences between, you know, transmission system and whatever assumptions we do for transmission system analysis and whatever we do for distribution system analysis, it is some, like many things are different, right? Yes. From configuration, if I say, and many things. So this was one thing I wanted to understand, like how it is different and what exactly analysis and what are the algorithms that they use for distribution system analysis and everything. So that was one reason I took up this subject. And when I took up this subject, I understood both of the things in much better way because we have already studied transmission analysis and everything, but no one ever told me, not even in my BTech or MTech, that distribution system analysis will be done in a different way. There are many parameters that changes when it comes to it. So in that way, it was very helpful for me. Like this course is mostly, you know, whoever does distribution designing or power system based companies who are into distribution sector. It is more of that kind of course. But for me, it was helpful in understanding how both of this analysis differs. And, you know, even if tomorrow someone asks me in the interview, I will be able to answer it in a much better way.
That's true.
It is very helpful. You should always do some different kinds of courses because there are many courses I do feel that we haven't done because electrical engineering is so vast and there are so many subjects. We can't do it everything, you know. Even that's when true. It comes to MTech, we have so many subjects and we cannot select all subjects. So it is very difficult. Except you, even if you go for PhD, there is a specialization, you know, you stick to one subject. So it is very difficult, but you should keep on learning, you know, that's whatever true. You feel that will upgrade your knowledge and help you understand things in a better way.
That's true. Yeah, there are so many things, but one thing I like in the entire your profile is all things are almost interrelated. Somehow it is helping you towards one final, for example, say PV systems or renewable or whatever you told. Your path is, it's almost helping you somehow. All the things, whatever is your graduation electrical and then your MTech power system and power electronics and then your research project or whatever you did. Everything is almost interrelated. It's taking you to the next level. So that's what generally people should do. Whatever NPTEL courses you did, those also helping your career. Because I see many people who are doing something irrelevant. Because if you have time, means that's okay. You can do that. That is a different thing. You can learn, if say you are electrical, you can learn IT Python language also. Who knows? That's okay. No, you can learn. That is your wish. But still, whatever your career is there, your aspirations, your vision is there. I want to be like that. My career should be like that. So if you have that projection, should keep on add branches along with that so that it will make you, it are the pillars for your career. Somehow it is your big tree in one day. So that thing, I very much observing everything. Yeah, I'm requesting our audience also the same thing. They also should
proceed. It is exactly true. You know, you should always you should have a target and you should work on that target. You know, if you are trying to go into designing field, for example, power system, there are many, you know, there is a electrical designing field into EPC based companies, and there are many into MEP field and everything. So if in general point of view, let us say if you are having a target of going into, for example, electrical designing field, so you know, you should then first try and research out things like what softwares you should learn, what are the softwares that company are using, and what kind of knowledge you should gain, and what kind of questions you should prepare for the same thing. Because you know, when you have that target, then you start researching what are the things going out there, and then you should start working on that. You must have also seen, like I have did some of the courses like LV distribution designing on ETAP, and then there is a Dialex and everything. So this was first I tried and researched something, like there are EPC based companies, there are MEP based companies. So basically people are using the softwares, like these are the common softwares that you get on the online platform also, and there are some softwares that company are using that no one can teach you, but the ETABs and Dialex are you know, one kind of software. Yeah, AutoCAD is there, which is easily available. You can easily learn this from any of the online, or even there are many coaching classes are also there. So you should try and learn at least those qualities or those softwares which are easily available. There are some softwares which are very specific to the company, and once you join, they will definitely teach you. But what you can learn yourself, you should definitely, you know, keep on learning. Yeah. So I can't say I'm very much well-versed with ETAP or Dialex, but at least if tomorrow I go and approach some company, definitely if they ask me like, what exactly is this software? Why have you studied? Yeah, what is the use of this software? So I can, you know, at least answer them and relate things, and, you know, even they will feel that, yeah, she's making an effort. If she joins her company, definitely she'll make more effort to understand things. So you should always set first target what exactly you want to go in, then start researching what exactly the companies are using and what is readily available. You should first learn that.
That's true. For continuation, please watch part 2 of this web interview. I hope you enjoy
this content. If you are watching this video for the first time, please subscribe to my channel. So press on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of my future videos. You will get notifications also. Thank you. Thanks for watching.